Hi, in this video, we're going to be talking about the aggregate planning and the three types of planning associated with this. And before I get into the three plans, let's talk about aggregate planning in summary. So aggregate planning, in definition, according to supply chain, means it's an approach to determine the quantity of goods, the timing of production to meet and satisfy the forecasted demand. So basically, aggregate planning is the main integral item to determine and to meet the forecasted demand. And under aggregate planning, there are many other constituents and many other components, such as the bill of materials, which determines the type of goods, the MPS, when to produce those goods, what time, in which week, I mean in a week, what goods they should produce. Like, it's like a timetable. So the aggregate planning is the main integral function to determine, to forecast the demand. And they need to find out two things, that is to find out the quantity of goods, the total quantity of goods to meet the demand, and the timing of production before when they should complete production to meet this demand. So to forecast the demand, you cannot just forecast demand. You need to have strategies, right? So aggregate planning has two main strategies, such as capacity options and demand options, to meet the forecasted demand. So capacity options, in short, basically means that you as an operations manager have certain control over certain variables. It comes under your capacity. You can make certain changes, like you can change the inventory levels, what to be shown in the market, what not to be shown in the market. You can subcontract work to other people who are much more efficient to do that work rather than your workers, basically outsourcing. And you can vary the workforce size, you can use part-time workers and so forth. So all these variables are under your capacity to change. And you in no way have influence over the demand. That's a separate option called the demand options, where you can influence the demand. So capacity options has no control over the change in demand, but only certain variables such as inventory, workers, etc. So demand options means you would be influencing demand. Now, how do you influence the demand? Now, for example, let's consider airlines. Airlines have many seasons. They have their holiday seasons where they can influence the demand. How? Through prices. If they lower the price, they have an influx of demand. They have high demand, and all that can be controlled through the demand options. So we have the three main plans, which I'm going to get into. Now, why do we have those three main plans? So we have the capacity options and demand options, and there are many different plans. These are all plans. But sometimes people found an easier way, that if you combine these two options, if you combine capacity options and if you combine demand options, you get more better results of your forecasted demand. You can get your responsibilities done in a much efficient manner, and that's why you have the three main plans. So these here are your three main plans. So these plans are a combination of capacity demand so that you can meet the forecasted demand accurately. So to understand these three plans in a, you know, in a definite manner, you will do certain examples, so it can be more easier for you to understand. But let's just go through this now, and we can introduce the idea of plans. It's chase strategy and level strategy. So the first plan, we can see that to maintain a constant workforce at a level necessary to meet the average demand. So again, like I said, we have combined the two options, right? The constant workforce. Now, workforce is an element that comes under capacity options. You're changing to use part-time workers, to contract, everything. The workforce comes under capacity options to meet the average demand, okay? And the second plan, to maintain a constant workforce at a level necessary to meet the lowest demand and to meet all the demand above it by subcontracting. And the last plan is to vary the workforce. So that's different from the former plans that we mentioned. Now here we're going to vary the workforce by hiring and laying off workers. So the production rate will be equal to the forecasted demand for each month. So I have squared up certain terms. So this is going to lead into our level strategy. Now, what is level strategy? Level strategy is a type of aggregate plan in which production is uniform or constant. So we can see that in the first plan, we are maintaining a constant workforce. right? So production is going to be constant. And yes, you're going to meet the average amount, but that doesn't matter. But for level strategy, you need to make sure that the production is constant or it's uniform. So here we can see that this is a level strategy. And same for plan 2 as well, because here we still maintain a constant workforce to meet the lowest demand. So it doesn't matter what we're trying to face, but we need to understand they're maintaining their workforce. It's a constant rate, it's uniform, it's stable throughout. So that's going to be level strategy as well. Wow, I'm so smart. I did not leave space to write level strategy, but okay, so this is going to be level strategy. All right. And plan 3. Now, plan 3 is different because we can see that we are not focusing on maintaining the workforce. We are varying the workforce here to vary the workforce by hiring and laying off workers. So in this way, the production rate will equal to the forecasted demand for each month. Now, again, that will be more easier for you to understand with the help of an example. But just know that since we are not having a constant workforce, we are not maintaining, we are not stabilizing the workers, we are just going to hire people and lay off people to meet the demand. The production rate will be equal to the demand, and I will be explaining to you that as well. But just know that to vary the workforce, that means it's going to be a chase strategy. All right. So now we're going to get into the examples of each of the plan. Now we're going to go step into plan 1.